Hello. Idira stares intently at the solid wall in front of her, shifting from foot to foot and biting her nails. The wall looks like an ordinary plasteel and rockreed surface, no different from any other in here. Lord Captain, this is it. The place from my visions. Even the scratches on the walls are the same, except for one thing. She points at the wall. That's where the door is supposed to be. The one I keep opening in my dreams every night. I've seen this moment so many times, it feels more real to me than I am. My visions couldn't have lied to me. Are you sure you are not mistaken? We can search for a while longer. I've never been more sure in my life. This is the spot. What if I just... Oh man. Oh boy. Oh jeez. Oh man. Idira steps closer to the wall and reaches out toward the non-existent door. As if in a trance, she clenches her finger as if gripping an invisible handle and slowly turns it. You hear a click. A violent ripple tears through the space around the wall. A cacophony of whispers makes your skin crawl from head to toe like an unseen wave emanating from twisted, broken reality. An even rays of impossible, nauseating light breaks through the rockcrete, forming the silhouette of a doorway. Eventually, the vision passes, and you clearly see a door where a blank wall used to be. Idira turns to you with a wide and somewhat deranged smile. Lord Captain, we found it. It's the door, exactly like the ones in my vision, which means my salvation is close. Except it wasn't hidden by some force field contraption. It was a powerful warp barrier. I could never have removed something like that. It's like our arrival was expected, and now they're inviting us in. We best be ready. Someone who knows their witchcraft is waiting inside. I don't usually go for this, but for once, let's just say that my faith in the Emperor is stronger than any warp trickery. He protects us. Lyra awkwardly clears her throat and nods, not looking too convinced. I hope you're right, Lord Captain. Taking a lightning bolt to the gut is something I'd like to avoid, so here's hoping the Emperor doesn't have anything more important to protect right now. Is there any... Let's just fucking go for this and see what happens. Hidden door... Secret wing of the laboratory. Build a bridge out of planks.
What is that stink? Is it coming from your cell? Are you brewing Fenrisian Mjad in there? I've heard of the stuff. I wouldn't say no to a taste.
You'd fucking die.
Mjad would eat away at your stomach and liver, swindler. Are you not satisfied with the number of augments you already have? Content yourself with sipping on booze intended for ordinary mortals.
Choose your own path. Too hard for a simple monkey.
Is there money to be made?
Disfigured bodies hang all over. This is not good. This is real bad. I see fucking skin flags. Low sticks, synth letter, corpse dosh.
My warp sight reveals something.
Thank you for seeing that, like, the second
success
before Jai stepped on it. I don't see anything here. Tank was shattered from the inside by an unthinkable force. Or something like that. Withered victim's face forever twisted in a silent scream. It's like being back in Komora, like we never left. Some more dark swiftness.
I always have a backup plan.
revolting biomass, some elements which can be interpreted as human features.
Watch your steps. Let us not dawdle.
No. Not that way.
I always get the job done.
Is there anyone up here? Is there anyone out there? Cause it's getting harder and harder to breathe.
What I found.
Do 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 do.
Just as I planned. Rise to the top, or get left in the dust.
I don't see nobody, and I kind of wanna go here and clear a passage.
My success was inevitable.
Oh right, cause fucking man.
Keep your wits about you.
Not having Argenta here is turning out to be a problem. Bodies of runaway test subjects failed to find a way out and died from hunger and disease.
Always keep your eye on the prize.
Take use.
And done.
Nice. What is this? Tiara of the Immaterium. Plus and suffers less warp damage. How about you throw that on? Huh. Runaway triple fade. Help never came. And this is where we can build a bridge. I'm not sure why we would want that. Maybe this is the only way out once shit goes bad inevitably. Oh boy, here we go. Drained Farseer. You see a contorted, agony-racked Eldari, or more accurately, something that resembles one. Dozens of scars and sutures cover his face. The sight of its misaligned joints moving under its skin makes your stomach turn, and its singular eye looks devoid of sanity. And yet, as you examine the creature's tattered clothes, you can still recognize, albeit with some difficulty, the ceremonial raiment of a Farseer. At last, my deliverance, monkey. The disgrace. The humiliation of failing at the hand of a lesser creature. Falling, even. Enough. The anticipation of this moment is all that has allowed me to retain a vestige of reason. End me now. Yuli takes a quivering breath. Who are you? I do not recognize you, but your vestments. A child of a dead home? I do not remember you, but it gladdens me on the cusp of death to behold a spark of the Asuriani. Who are you? A hollow shell forced into servitude. Every thread of my being calls out to me, urging me to claim your lives, only stopped by the fading remnants of my former self. Quickly, I demand that you give me my death to me and break the shackles of this nightmare. The Farseer's crooked finger reached for his temples, and now you notice the sinister-looking device on his head. Translucent threads coil in strange, sickening patterns around the Eldari's temples, sinking into the skin of his face, neck, and clavicles. The dim, cold light of the laboratory, the device resembles glistening carrion worms that are mercilessly drinking the Xenos mind dry. Idira gives you a puzzled glance. I think that's what we're here for. I can barely see the Xenos aura in the warp. Must be the work of that thing on his head. Hmm. So what are you? Tevantia's plaything. The master used me. By means of that which now entangles my mind and bends me and my powers to its will. I am the tool that conceals the lair from prying eyes with the energies of the veil. Had the monkey seer not heard my pleas for help, you never would have found me. Huh. Your pleas for help? Eldario doubles over in an anguished paroxysm, his voice ringing like a taut string. My silent cries pierce the veil, as in the visions of this prison beyond its walls. They carried with them all my dreams of deliverance and liberation. Is that not the reason for your coming? Dira bursts out laughing, her voice hoarse in a circle. Oh, this half-baked guff is killing me. What, does it that mean it wasn't my own salvation I saw in my dreams? It was this half-dead Xeno's deliverance? Come off it. Don't you buy any of this crap, Lord Captain. He's just trying to mess with our heads. I have no reason to lie to you, monkey. However, your beliefs are of no matter. You're already here, which means I will finally die. I have never been merciful to Xenos. I have no desire to start now. Let him suffer until death claims him.
He was tortured by the same Xenos who held you captive and brutally murdered your friends. You are your comrades in misfortune in a way. Don't you have any sympathy for him at all?
Comrades? What in the Kraken's arsehole are you talking about?
Ulfar shakes his head, perplexed.
I am a descendant of the Allfather, and he is a vile inhuman. Compare me with a knife made of honest plasteel, broken in the homunculus hand.
sorry. Oh, fuck. The voice is hard to do.
You will find more similarities than I have with this wretch. He can suffer. You can see that he is no commoner, so he's no doubt he has no doubt done his share of vile deeds in his life.
This makes me seem greedy, I think, rather than wanting him to live. Or does it? I'm not sure what the tone is of this. All I need is the implant on your head. Give it to me and I shall set you free. Should we say that? Say it. The Eldari hisses and howls, his crooked fingers tearing his ragged robes apart.
It is too late. My mind is potioned. My soul is marred. I don't know what purpose you need this cursed machine, monkey. But if your mind carries a shred of reason, then destroy it along with me.
Dira suddenly leans forward, anger and desperation are written all over her face.
Not a chance, Xenos. That thing, that sight stifler, it will save my life. You're just weak. That's why you can't handle it. Naive child, you would condemn yourself to a fate of true horror. Heed me when I say there are things far worse than death.
What makes this device so dangerous?
It hides the soul within the warp from the spawn of chaos, without severing its connection to real space. And it slowly consumes the soul. Day after day, the soul erodes and withers until nothing remains but emptiness.
Is that right? You certainly talk a lot for someone who's supposed to be empty. Before all this, you must have never shut up.
I spent aeons harnessing my gift. I guided an entire world. My gaze pierced the future, looking epochs ahead. And even I am, at my limit, clinging desperately to the meager relics of what I once called my soul, just to speak another word. Who gave you the audacity to think you will fare any better?
Fuck it. I shall grant you a swift death.
Let it be so.
Farsi arises from his knees in a jerking motion, like a broken marionette, and takes a step toward you with glassy eyes. Oh no. His frail fingers move as if tugged by invisible strings, and the mutilated bodies of the twisted creatures in the tanks start convulsing synchronously. In frightening unison, their unblinking eyes shift to you. That's bad. This is very bad. Ambushed, battle begins. Very well. Oh god, these are actually kind of bad.
I don't need luck. I have strategy.
Oh shit. Irliot goes. Oh man, this is real bad, dude. I'm gonna do that in the hopes of helping some of my buddies. And I'm gonna do... I feel like he needs to go. Might as well. I don't know if... should I... let's actually give that to Ulf for this time. And we are in a rough spot.
Heal my wounds.
Okay, okay. How about you run all the way over here? We do this.
If you insist, Lord Captain.
We do that.
I am a navigator, not a servitor.
We do it again, because we can.
Is this a job for the serfs?
You a pitiful attempt.
Don't frighten me.
Well, we do this and hope that Ulfar can fucking do some damage at the very least. Can you get all the way over here? No, you cannot. You can kind of move though. What if I do this?
So it shall be.
If I do that, then I can go here. Oh fuck, that's not good.
Heal my wounds. I hunger for
you. Do that. Move the zone.
If you insist, Lord Captain.
Bang. Nice. Good. Bang.
Pay dearly for your actions.
Fucking as much damage as we can to this man. Oh fuck. Okay, that's not too bad. Can you stop doing that? You're gonna fucking degrade the veil, whatever thing. Oh shit, here it comes. Okay. Oh, successful. Okay. Okay, how about take aim?
Tell me, and it is done.
And then you go bang. Oh shit. I don't... okay. I don't... what the fuck? I guess we kill him. Finish that guy, please. And then I'm gonna say... no, wait. Oh, I guess yes. I got these mixed up. I don't know what either does. Let's be real. Oh shit, this is bad.
I answer the call.
Okay, so...
too bad I never leave that on
trails of fate.
Okay.
Me.
So far, so good. I'm just gonna fucking Hail Mary run.
I approach the designated position.
Okay, good. Ineffectual, ineffectual. This guy is successful.
I am
That's great.
The ancestors.
This tedium has been.
Ancestors, guide me.
My heart sinks with the thrill of battle.
Oh, that's not great. Will he? I will see. Scanalyze this guy,
if I must.
And then do that thing on him.
I am not your Xenos pet monkey.
Okay, fucking Jai. What do we do with you? Nothing. To be honest. Can you just kill him? Thank you. And then just... I should probably have moved you, honestly, now that I think about it. I don't know how to use that, so I'm not gonna... I'm just gonna hang out here and not do anything.
I do not fear a perilous path. We all walk our own path. Your path ends here.
Okay, thanks for that.
I do not fear a perilous path.
All of these things are not very good. Can you no, please? That's really bad.
I do not fear a perilous path.
Another voice to join my choir.
What? Okay. Okay. I thought that was not calculated.
I'll see to it personally.
I will do that because I think I can move it with Cassia, but right this second I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that.
It's as good as
fuck. Oh shit, we got Idira sitting right there. That's not great either. If you were to go here, give me another turn. I do this to get those guys out of the way. In fact, I do this as well. Is that the best?
Me? If you insist, Lord.
I think that's better.
Isn't this a job for the serfs?
Ulfar gets another turn.
I shall prevail.
I challenge you, Damget. See how the wolves.
You go here and do that. Great. Good. Can you actually do that?
You will pay dearly for your actions.
And that. You give this guy a kick. And then you can do like one of these.
I'll return this favor tenfold.
And it genuinely feels like you got a fucking space marine when you play with Ulfar. What a fucking beast.
I'm not accustomed to being ordered around.
Do that.
You gotta reload. And apparently that gives a fucking opportunity attack. Didn't even know that. We'll do that. We'll do this. Give him a fucking kick. He's on the floor, and that's where I like him. Okay, good. Jai.
You've got a problem? I've got a price.
Smack. Kick. How about we just do this one and have you go bang? Bang. Oh, fuck. Fuck. Is he like just not possible to hit from there? I don't fucking know.
I can do that with the right incentive.
That's good.
I want a medal for that one.
Give him a
Me?
Oh no, okay.
Never in a thousand sectors.
Do that. Might as well.
And it is done.
And he's gonna get a turn. Here's your turn.
I do not fear a perilous path.
Okay, good. Vale seems to be holding up. Give him one of these.
Was it you?
Attempt.
Scan him.
Anything else?
Expose, I guess.
Will do.
Do I have eyes on him? I do.
I'll see to it personally.
Just for safety.
Who, if not me?
And then gun.
I'll make it happen.
Into the
dark. Okay. Idira carefully pulls the threads of the Psi Stifler out of the Farseer's breathless body. The strange device glimmers ominously in her hands, and it is difficult to tell in the dim light if its threads are moving on their own or if it's because her whole body is trembling. Terrified and confused, Idira looks at the device, then at you, and then at the dead Eldari. That Xenos! Jane, did you see his eyes right before he attacked us? It was like there was no light left in them. And if it's all because of this thing? I don't want to die, but I don't want to live like that either. If it means I'll stop being myself, then what's the point? Irliot is warily observing Idira from under lowered lids. You do not have to resort to a solution like this. There are other ways. My kind have other technology, devices not designed purely to scourge the soul. Oh yeah, Red, I'm sure they do. And as soon as I visit your nearest and dearest, I'm sure they welcome me with open arms and spoil me with gifts. Look, Irliot, if you're not on great terms with them, then what are the chances? Then what chance does a monkey witch have? I could say this. I kind of... Had I spent more time with Adira and done more of her stuff, maybe. But I'm gonna go with this. Break that abominable device. Robbing yourself or your soul is never the way. Yes, yes, you're right. This crap isn't worth it. Time to accept the inevitable. I can entertain these fantasies of a nice long life all I like, but that's all they'll ever be. Fantasies. Pretty tales to tell over a glass of Amasek to make life seem less shitty. The reality of the situation is ugly and merciless. I'm a psyker. My abilities are getting more and more out of control by the day, which means I'll go out like any psyker should. It'll be ugly and merciless. Best I can hope for is that it'll be so fragging awesome and heroic that you'll be telling stories of it to your grandchildren for ages. Ha! Thank you for helping me realize this, Jane. Dira sniffles and casually drops the Psi Cipher to the floor where it shatters into a million tiny pieces. Pretty sure we're done here. Lord Captain, mind letting me know when you have some time once we're back on the ship? I want to talk to you about plans for the future in private. Can we go now? I've still got a whole life to get on with. Oh, that wasn't a very beautiful fight. Why did the fucking icons... Why can't I loot anyone? Why can't... I'm gonna quick save. And I'm gonna load it. Okay, thank you. Force your measure. Oh, and it's not even. Well, this is kind of cool. Staff gains plus in penetration. Okay. Neat. And now, earlier it has broken ribs, which affects strength and. AP is not great, but she usually has more AP than I know what to do with, so. I'm okay with that. I don't know why the injuries don't show the way they should, but it is what it is. Anything else I'm missing? Doesn't seem like it. But that was that whole thing. I guess we have a follow-up with Adira once we get back to the ship. Right now... we have Tervantius, and I don't have the best team for that fight, I feel, money to be made. But it is what it is. I'm gonna save here. This was a whole episode, I think. I'm gonna save here, and I'll be back on the next one. See you later.